Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 80, and here I am going to discuss the optical isomerism of the compounds containing two asymmetric carbon atoms. And I have already told you the asymmetric carbon atom means those carbon atoms which are having different types of substituents or group of atoms. So if such compounds which are having two asymmetric carbon atoms, what will be the number of isomers? The formula of isomer is, that is n square, n stands for number. If asymmetric carbon atom is one, there will be two isomers. If asymmetric carbon atoms are two, there will be four isomers. If asymmetric carbon atoms are three, then there will be six isomers. So it goes to multiply like that. So here I have shown you there are two isomeric forms. I mean four isomeric forms are there. They are given here on the blackboard. Number 1, 2, 3 and 4. And here some are superimposable and some are not superimposable. And in spite of that fact that they are not superimposable, still they are optically active. And such optically active compounds are called diastereomers because they are not enantiomers. Enantiomers means they are having mirror image. So there are some ones which are not mirror image and some are mirror image and they are optically active. So here these four are there, and here this one can be the mirror image of this one, and this one can be the mirror of this one. But this and this cannot be the mirror image of. They are diastereomers, and this are also diastereomers. So two type of conditions are there. Either the out of four isomers, either they are enantiomers or they are diastereomers, means they are not enantiomers, they are not mirror images, but still they are optically active. So when organic compounds containing two asymmetric carbon atom, it can give four. N stands for number of asymmetric carbon atom, possible isomers. The form 1 and 2 are enantiomers. 1 and 2 are enantiomers because they are mirror image of each other and they are optically active, are enantiomers. And so number 3 and number 4, so they are enantiomers. 1 and 2 are enantiomers and 3rd and 4th are enantiomers. It is clear from the above example containing two asymmetric carbon atoms, the form 1 and 3 are not mirror images. Number 1 and number 3, they are not mirror images. It's not possible. They are diastereomers. And number 2 and number 4, they are not mirror images. They are diastereomers. So, yet they are optically active isomers. Same in the case of number 2 and number 4. Such organic compounds are called diastereomers. They will be having different physical properties. In continuation, now I am giving you the specific example by taking tartaric acid. So here in tartaric acid, there are two asymmetric carbon atoms, and because of two asymmetric carbon atoms, four isomers are possible. And on the plane, for our convenience, it is I have written here four isomeric forms, and the one is this, and the mirror image of that one, which can be divided into two half, is the second one, and third one, it is shown with the arrow, the rotation of each group, either hydrogen or hydroxy, and how they are, the third one is changed into fourth one. So this is the optical isomerism of tartaric acid. Here the carbon atom is attached to the groups hydrogen, hydroxy and COS. These three type of substituents are there which are attached, linked to carbon atom. One is hydrogen, second one is hydroxy group and third one is COS. That's why the two carbon atoms in tartaric acid, they are asymmetric and we are getting four isomers. TOS. This molecule can be represented by the space model of two tetrahedral joint corner. But for the sake of convenience, here we are using plain formulae. It is in continuation of the optical isomerism of tartaric acid, and I have already given you the four structure. And in these four structures, number one and two, especially the number two, if you rotate on paper plane to 180 degree, that one can be cancelled. I have shown you the dotted line. So actually, there are only three form of, isomeric structures of tartaric acid. Number one, three and four. One is cancelled if it is rotated at 90 degree. And out of these four, number three, where it is rotating, you have seen the arrow in right direction. OH is shifted from here and the other H is shifted to this one. So that rotating a plane polarized light in right direction is called dextro tartaric acid, and that is given by D tartaric acid. And the fourth one, where it is left direction rotation of plane polarized light, and that's why it is called Leo rotatory tartaric acid, and it is given by L tartaric acid. And the first one is inactive form, and that is meso form. So these are the three structures. When formula one is rotated through 180 degree in the plane of paper, becomes identical with formula 2. So formula 1 and formula 2, once it is rotated at 180 degree, they will become identical. So out of these two, only one is taken because they are identical to formula 2. Therefore, for tartaric acid, we can have only three different arrangements, like 1, 3 and 4 structures. So the structure 3 will rotate the plane polarized light to right direction and will represent D tartaric acid, that is dextro form. In the same way, the fourth structure will rotate the plane polarized light to left direction and will represent, that is Leo tartaric acid, that is given by L tartaric acid. In structure 1, that is structure 1, structure 1 will represent optically inactive tartaric acid. It is known as meso tartaric acid, that is given by M tartaric acid. So here, three type of optically, we can say isomeric form, or the optical isomerism of tartaric acid, where it contains two asymmetric carbon atoms, three forms are there. The one which is meso form, other one it is dextro form, that is D tartaric acid, and third one that is L tartaric acid. Thank you very much.